thing, it's a new thing. Check out this, I bring a older roll below the level, cause I'm living low next to the bass.
Come on,
turn up the radio, they're claiming I'm a criminal, but now I wonder how, some people never know. The enemy could be the friend guardian, I'm now a hooligan, I rock the party and clear all the madness. I'm not a racist, preach to teach the
cause some they never had this.
Number one, never wanna run about the gun, I wasn't licensed to have one.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This is the one and only DJ Skyrocket. And you can see I have my partner in crime. We're back again. Season number two. Don't believe the hype. We're back. I don't know why they did this to themselves, but we are back. Yes, right. Bouknight Picks a Line presents DJ Skyrocket and Friends. Or as I can say tonight, DJ Skyrocket and Family. Because this is my cousin. This is my cousin, my Ace Boon Coon.
SoujaBoi up in here.
The one and only statistician, SoujaBoi, is in the building. One half of the remake tag team. Here we go. Once again. Me and, hey, some, real quick, something y'all don't know. Back in the 90s, me and SoujaBoi, we went up to Carowinds. And rocked the show up there at Carowinds and did a demo that went wood. It went wood. We did a video, and lo and behold, we can't find the video. But the video resurfaced every once in a while. The video resurfaced like every 6 or 7 years. They were like, we ran across that video. And I'm like, wait a minute.
You like to break that video out every now and then.
I said, man, wait a video. I want to see the video. Because I was skinny back then. But we are here to talk about everything you want to know in the sporting world. Our main thing is the ECBL. Ladies and gentlemen, that is the East Coast Basketball
ECBL
League.
Back
we're back with the ECBL. Most of y'all don't know, I have been working with the ECBL, or the Carolina Crusaders. For the last, 10, 11 years. And I am their entertainment director, the color commentator, the video man, and if need be, I'll be the towel boy wiping up the sweat off the floor as we go. You know me.
Well,
hey.
I tell you what though, man. We ready for it this year, man. Everybody at them zeros. That's where everybody want to be right now, man. All your Northeast, your Northwest, your Southern Conference, Southeast, Southwest Division. Y'all ready, man. Y'all ready. Let's see what it do this year, though.
Hey, it's going to be some noise. It's going to be some noise being made this year because, listen, my underdog, well, your underdog, I talk trash to them, but they know it's all in love. And, I have to say congratulations to the defending ECBL champions. Those, it just killed me to say their name. It just killed me to say their name. I'm just going to say their own name. Sebastian Page is the coach. I'm not going to say the team. Because listen, I gave Sebastian so much flack about his team. It was all in love. We was all having fun. But, I mean, he sent me a message and said, you know, I don't lose in Columbia. I said, okay, we'll see about that. So right after the ECBL, they had the Pro-Am League that started in Columbia this year. And he brought them same boys down here, and they ran the table. They ran the table on them boys. And all he could say afterwards was, I told you so. I like, man, I ain't want to hear that. I ain't want to hear that. I'm mad. Don't talk to me right now. I'm mad. Don't talk to me right now. But we're getting ready to get started on the exciting league in the ECBL. We are getting ready. We have a preseason game coming up this Saturday with the, who they are? Let's see. They are the Let It Fly Web Dogs. And they will be going against Kingdom Life Basketball Club. Now, we don't know anything about Kingdom Life. They're a new team to the ECBL. We'd like to say welcome. You will get your 5 minutes of shine right now. I don't know anything about y'all. I looked up y'all roster.
They from Inman.
Inman, South. Yeah, we talked about Yeah, Inman is up there by Greenville. Yeah.
I think they got some nice golfing out there, man.
I don't know, but I remember I Googled Inman and what school they go to out there, high school. And if they got any of them boys that played high school ball, they should be a team to be reckoned with. They keep a good, strong high school team. And, you know, to play in the ECBL, you have to be at least 18. I'm sorry, 18 and older. You have to be over 18 to play. It is an adult travel basketball league. We're all on the East Coast. We're one of the biggest semi-pro league on the East Coast. I think we have 25 teams. Anyway, from 20 to 25 teams this year, waiting on the official rosters to be released of the players. That should be coming out this week, and then we'll be able to dig in what former NBA players, overseas player, or college greats that's on what team. But I know the defending champs are coming back. And they're going to bring some noise. I think he kept his team together. They was a running team. They're basically young team. So they should be good. Of course, you know, preseason picks, we should have those primetime players should be back. You know, Chris Allen keep a good team. With his squad up there out of North Carolina. They're the Rock Hill area. I don't know if I'm going to take the Carolina Thunder is the name of the team. I can go ahead and say their name now. Carolina Thunder is the champion. They are the defending champion. I don't know what they bring it back, but I know I have inside information.
Yeah.
Because I work with the Carolina Crusaders, so you know I got inside information. So I talked to the owner of the Carolina Crusaders, the one and only Francis Marion Great, Christian Dickerson, about the team this year. And she said, we're going to make some noise. I said, all right, we're going to make some noise. So, I asked her, do we have a theme song this year? We're going to be like Dion. We're going to come out with a theme song this year.
No.
So, it might be we ready or we don't win that many games. It might be the wheels on the bus go round and round. We not sure what we going to do. But we're going to have a good time. All right, so Mr. Guru, we're shooting in the dark. We got the Let It Fly Web Dogs versus the Kingdom Life Basketball Club. Right. We don't know anything about these teams.
Right.
But I think the Web Dogs going to pull it out. And the reason I say that, because the Web Dogs played in the league last year, and I know what they can bring to the table. Okay. I'm not sure about Kingdom Life. So we're not gonna actually put Web Dogs plus six. I put it out there. Web Dogs minus six. I want them to be the favorite. Well, Web Dogs minus six.
I don't know nothing about Inman, South Carolina.
Okay, what you
want to
know about Inman?
They got about 35 people that live there.
You know? Yeah. So, they got about six liquor stores.
They probably got a liquor store for every 300 people.
And then they got, I bet you they got some cornhole out there.
They probably got cornhole.
And some horseshoes.
They probably got some hella fine horseshoes out there.
Yeah.
So, you know, they got some major players on that, man. Let's see what names still out there that's holding on to any spots. You know, when it comes down to when we get to these playoff areas, man. So that's what I'm looking at. But I like the fact that we're going in right now and we're looking at these teams. You know, we don't know nothing about it. Everybody's zeroed out. You know what I'm saying? Rosters are gonna change. You know, all the personnel are gonna change. You might even have a few coaching changes that happen. You know what I mean? You might just have some teams that just submit because they don't want to be in the league because they get beat up on so bad. You know. So, the name of their gym is Better Built Basketball Training Facility. Well, I mean, if they come from a facility, that's like a Street Fighter versus a boxer.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, this dude, he affiliated with this boxing gym right here. So you probably don't want to really mess with him. You know what I mean? So that shows some structure right there. So that's cool. And I'm pretty sure they both got some pretty talented basketball players, man. So, especially the talent nowadays, man. They got a lot of guys out there.
Oh, I got the roster. They done been released. All right. So let's see.
But we still don't have no, you know. The rosters look good, so they're just names on rosters. You know what I'm saying?
Well, I got the attributes.
It's a name on the jersey is what that is.
I got the attributes. I got the height. I got the weight, and I got some of them hometown. It looked like Kingdom Life when they got a lot of players from North Carolina. Okay, so looking at the roster, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. They got 8 players they showing for Monroe, North Carolina.
Okay.
One of their players, the guard, George Stevenson, he played at Erskine College.
Okay, okay.
Last year he played for Let It Fly Web Dogs.
Oh no.
And looking at his stats, last season he put up 42 points.
Okay, now you gotta start paying attention.
Total scoring points was 120. He had 9 steals, but he turned the ball over 22 times.
No, it's a short season.
He turned the ball over 22 times.
Well, I don't know if you can score 40 some points a game, you make up for a lot of that.
So that's Kingdom Life Basketball Club, that's Northeast Division right there. Yeah.
But you know they play some hard nose. You got the Fayetteville Panthers. You got Roy County Bulls. The Winston-Salem Wolves. Okay, all right. That's that Northeast Division. Northwest.
That's the Northern Conference.
You got the Carolina Chosen Lions. Now I don't know these guys. The Seven City Vets.
That's a new team.
Okay, that's a new team,
and the DC Heat.
But you see some of the better teams. You got Petersburg Cavaliers and North Carolina.
Now Peterburg's made the championship game last year. They lost to Carolina Thunder in the championship game. The Chosen Lions made a run in the playoffs last year. I remember them.
They made a run.
So it's that North is going to be stacked. It looked like
North is going to be crazy. Southern Conference looked pretty good. You know, Carolina Crusaders. Okay.
Hey, 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 hey. And I'm finna tell you what we bring to the table. We bring some thunder. Forget the lightning.
Guard City Magic gonna handle y'all.
No, you don't.
Bruh.
I see us in our division. I see us second in our division.
Second after how many games?
No, at the end of the season, right before the playoffs. We'll be number two. Okay. We'll be number two in our division, number three in the South in the Southern Conference. I got prime time coming out the west, out the southwest. That'll be prime time all day. Oh, Carolina, yeah. I don't know. Carolina Tribe. Listen, Carolina Tribe made a run last year, remember? They made a run. Carolina, I know the people that's on here be like, who are these teams? Listen, if you want to watch some exciting basketball, the NBA is good. But ain't nothing like the ECBL, bro. I'm telling you right now. And listen, I'm not gonna tell you, I'm not saying that because I work for a team in the ECBL. Listen, if you're talking about some hard nosed basketball playing where they get down and dirty, you need to come to an ECBL game. Find an ECBL team in your area. Listen, go online, Google East Coast Basketball League. East Coast Basketball League. Search your area. I guarantee you got a team. If you live on the East Coast, you got a team playing close to you somewhere. Go check out a game. Go check out one game and let me know what you think. I can't sell it to you. You got to see it yourself. You got to see it yourself. You got to see it yourself.
Your area. Check it out.
Yeah.
Check it out.
Now, listen. Now, since we're talking about basketball, we got to talk about the upset of the year. Do you believe? That's all I want to know. Do you believe?
I believe, but I gotta tell you what I believe, so I know what I believe.
South Carolina.
No, I don't believe, but I believe.
South Carolina Gamecocks.
Yeah.
Whoop up on Kentucky. Yesterday by 17 last night. Held Kentucky to their lowest point total for the season at 62 points.
That was a beatdown, man. I can't say beatdown.
It shocked the world.
Let's say that's impressive.
Listen, you know, normally after the game, the security detail try to stop the players. I mean, stop the fans from running on the court. When 1 minute was left, they just dropped the rope and said, man, forget it. Y'all go at it. They finally got there. All zeros went on the clock. The fans rushed the court. Oh, we're going to get fined for that. USC got fined for that. They got fined for that. But, hey, they're going to pay that fine willingly. So, after, I'll tell you what you don't know. So, after the game, they cleared the court, and USC got this big old fountain outside Colonial Life Arena. It was 30-something degrees yesterday. Depending on where you was. Yeah. Them jokers were jumping in the fountain. Taking off the shirt, jumping in the fountain, and trying to swim around the fountain. Now, the fountain ain't number 3 feet deep. They tried to Boy, Carolina don't know how to act, cold. I know they made some.
They take out that number one seed. That was number one seed, though.
No, that was number six. They was number six.
Oh, that was number six.
But that's, so in quad one wins, USC is now 2-1. That's, they call them quad one, quad two. And this is what the selection committee look at to determine who's going to go to the big dance. They look at your quality wins, quality losses, all this other stuff. So they break everything down to, analytics and whatnot. really and truthfully it's supposed to be, but you know, they go away from. But so Carolina is 2-1 in quad ones wins. That's, boy, that's a mouthful. They 2-1. Now in quad two wins, they are 5-0 in quad two wins. So if the playoffs was to start, if the selection committee was to meet tomorrow, Carolina would be a number 8, number 9 seed.
Okay, that's a good place.
Number 8, number 9 seed. So they would go against, if they was the number 8, they'll go against the number 9 seed.
Yeah.
So they will go against, it'll be a playing game. And then the winner of that will go in. Carolina already be put in the field of 62, and it's 4 playing game. So Carolina should, they'll have 2 teams to play in. The winner of that will be the 9 seed on that side of the bracket. Should be. No, the playing games go to 16. So Carolina have a, hey man, there's so much to think about, shoot. My head hurt. Listen, man. Listen. Are you still crying?
Why? Still crying. You know what, man?
Are you still?
You know what? Come on, man. Yeah, everybody should be scared. I'm gonna tell you this, why everybody should be scared. And I'm gonna let you know. Before I tell y'all why I think everybody should be scared. I'm just gonna let everybody know they should be scared. Alright? And if you ain't scared yet, you need to be. Because now I'm gonna tell you why. We had a brand new quarterback. Brand new. He might be a freshman. He had a freshman quarterback. brand new coach. Went behind the ears. A lot of football, you know, proud stuff. But brand new, first year out there. What do we do with one of the strangest teams out there? One of the newest teams out there. Them Texans actually made it to a point to make it that far with what we have. It's crazy. So you got to look at, next year be like a rebuild year. Let's look at 2 years from now.
What college did Watson go to? What state is he from?
Georgia.
No, sir. He went to Clemson. And I'm not a Clemson fan, but he's from South Carolina. So I got, listen.
But regardless, I will take nothing away from Deshaun Watson. But Deshaun Watson, he stayed with the Texans for three years?
No. He stayed longer than that.
But either way, Deshaun Watson didn't make it to this point on his rookie season.
Because they had a bunch of busters then.
Well, that's what I'm saying. You restructure a whole team around, but you got to restructure a team. You got to, but all I'm saying is they had the right pieces this year. And you know they had the right pieces because we had so many rookies this year, all the way to the head coach.
He was with the Texans 4 years.
See?
2017, 2020.
He didn't do what Dak Prescott did when he stepped in. Remember when Dak Prescott stepped in? It was like, oh, this is our guy now. It only took him one game to shine. You know what I mean? You should know this, Cowboys. and Dak Prescott has been the man ever since then. All he had to do was get on the field. Got his opportunity. And it was like, oh, no. That's all we need.
That's all y'all need.
Hey,
see what you ain't gonna do. What you ain't gonna do.
Did he make him retire?
Hey.
Tony didn't hurt for a week. That internet took a man's job. Come
Listen.
Come on.
Listen.
But y'all already know. So why would I be upset at what the Texans did this year? Because it was, and matter of fact, I'm gonna put it this way too, because my mama called me and said, What's up with your boys? And, you know, my mama does. She just hang out with the guys in the shop down there. So it ain't like, you know, she really into the sports like that. But everybody in the shop watching that game against the Baltimore Ravens and the Houston Texans, and my mama called me. Talking about, son, what's wrong with your team? I said, what you mean, what's wrong with my team?
Can I tell you a secret?
What?
They paid your mama to make that call. They paid your mama.
That's what it was.
Hey, can they know? Kevin, what's up, Kevin? Kevin Mayo say, what's up? Hey, listen.
Oh, listen.
Yeah, let me tell you. If you would have got, let's talk about this. If you would have got a call from your daddy, your uncles, Booty, or Bernard, would you picked up the phone?
Yeah, I would have.
You would have.
Yeah.
I find that hard to believe.
Because I'm watching the game too. Because if I did pick up the phone, then that means I'm disappointed in the team. So in no way I'm gonna give you the impression that I'm disappointed in how far they made it. Like, I mean, come on. Why would I do that? Why would I ghost them?
If I had that,
he just happened to have to run into Baltimore one of their best times, man. And Lamar Jackson just did his thing. That's all I can say, man.
Okay, so speaking about Lamar Jackson, let's talk about the lineup. Let's talk about the matchups for this weekend. We got the Lions versus the 49ers. Who you got?
Oh man.
Detroit is playing with a purpose.
You're digging deep on this.
Detroit is playing with a purpose. The 49ers is without Debo. Well, he's questionable.
You know what? Honestly, I would go with Detroit. I'd pick Detroit on this one right here. And I don't have no Detroit is due. The Lions are just due. This is just, you know what I'm saying? To get to this point right here. You don't weather the storm. You know what I mean? So this is the time right here. So I would go with Detroit, man.
Now you say you're taking Detroit. Are you going with the line?
What's the line?
The line is 7. San Francisco is giving Detroit 7.
So why is San Francisco giving Detroit 7?
Because after San Francisco's last game,
I would take that spread.
Because of the analytics of the game, man.
Absolutely, I would take that spread right now. Absolutely. Seven, I'd take that spread.
So San Francisco is giving Detroit 7 points.
Yeah.
All right. So you take Detroit.
All right, and then the next game, which is the early game,
is the Kansas City Chiefs versus
the Ravens.
Ravens are favored by -3.5.
That's a wash to me right there.
That's a trap game.
That's a wash. It's gonna be a good game. That's a wash to me. So I wouldn't take the line on that.
So who you take on the straight win?
I think Baltimore win it by three.
So Baltimore win by three and they giving up 3.5. So that means they'll lose if somebody take the line. Because they'll lose by the half.
Yeah.
Okay. So your Super Bowl picks then, if I remember correct, it'll be Baltimore versus Detroit, right?
Baltimore and Detroit. That's what I'm looking at.
And who you think?
The winner of that?
Yeah.
But I got to see how they play right here. And then who get injured, don't get injured. You know what I mean? It'd be hard to say that right now. But if they were, if everybody stay healthy, everybody, you know, playing the way they are, I'll stick with the Ravens, bro. I say the Ravens will probably outmatch any remaining teams right now. They're the better team. As long as nothing happens with Lamar, of course, you know, they'll be good because it's hard to contain that dude. They done found that out in several games. So you can't keep him in the pocket. And then when you try to keep him in the pocket, he don't learn to roll out nicely. He don't learn to get down the field. You know, he don't learn to make better decisions in the pocket. So, Baltimore got it this year. That's my pick.
And you can bet on that. Well, listen, we got to say hey to the people that's watching real quick. Like I said, Cousin Kevin say what's up.
What's up, cuz? We got the one and only. Love the album, bro. Love the album.
Oh, hold up. Kevin got an album out?
Yeah, man.
I ain't got
it. It's Kevin 1100, man. You don't know about him.
Kevin need to bring me an album this Friday night. He need to send me something.
He sent me his last album, man.
I just need a cut.
With all tracks on it, man. It go over your head if you ain't a thinking type person, man.
I need a cut. Out Kevin, this Friday. This Friday night, Kevin, I will be at Quaker State and Lube on Bluff Road, 5 o'clock. I start at 7, DJ. Come by and see me and bring me something. I had to put
bring
that
him,
out.
Bring him something.
I had to bring me something. Then we got Marlena.
Love you, Lil.
We got Marlena. Listen, let me tell you. Marlena was a beast in high school. Now you talking about can run up and down the court. She was Lisa Leslie of Richland County basketball. Richland County School District 1 basketball. Remember when Lisa Leslie was there? When she first came to the Spark, nobody could stop her. They couldn't stop Malena. Malena tried to dunk. She couldn't dunk. She couldn't get up there. But when she go down like she finna go up there, everybody just move out the way. Because they know. She bringing the thunder. And then we got my boy Taz. Another bowler, he just talked trash. He out there in the Midwest. He out there in Tennessee, Mississippi. He's somewhere between Mississippi and Tennessee, but he on here watching. And then we got our cousin Kathy is on here. And then we got our cousin David Sumner on here. So we going to say hey to everybody. We're going to give you a shout out. And if you don't agree with what we say, just type it in and we'll talk about it. Now we do. Now, since we still talking about, I'm finna set you up. Since we talking about football, what do you think about Jim Harbaugh leaving Michigan and going to the Chargers?
I can't even say that.
I got to get close to hear those.
No, because I got I don't even know what you would even expect me to say about that. You know what I'm saying? It's a career move. You know? I mean, what you want me to say?
The man just won the national championship.
It's a career move, man. I don't know. Maybe there's longevity somewhere else. You know what I'm saying?
He was in the league before, and he left the league and went to Michigan.
That's what I'm saying. I don't. How does anybody know? You know.
Taz said that's the setup. Thank you, cuz. Taz said that's the setup too.
Y'all gotta explain it to me.
I think, and this is just me talking. I'm trying to see if I can find what the. This is just me talking. I think he left, but he carried that dark cloud with him. Even though he got the two suspensions, he's still going to carry a dark cloud wherever he go. People going to watch him and be like, okay, y'all got to watch him. He cheesed the one out. Anybody closely affiliated with him or that team will be under scrutiny. And either he should have stayed one more year in Michigan or just take a year off and let that die down. That's what he should have did. Well, that's just my take on it. He should have just either stay in Michigan or ride the wave and take a couple of years off.
He spent a few seasons here and a few seasons there. It's not like that's something new. You know what I mean? I mean, he was four seasons with the 49ers?
Uh-huh.
You know what I mean? And then he moved from there. I mean,
So Taz said he went from coaching the Niners and losing the Super Bowl to his big brother to go coaching his alumni. And got a ship to now. I don't know what that all that mean. You ready to come back to the league? I don't know what that is. So I get what he's saying. He said he was in the league. Lost Super Bowl. Yeah. With the coach at his alma mater to build his how can I put it? To build his clout.
Well, you know what? Despite all that, the man leaving Michigan to go coach the Chargers, right?
Yes.
So what's there to even worry about? I mean, that's a career decision. He's going from Michigan to coach the Los Angeles Chargers.
Yes. But ain't the Chargers supposed to be trying to move to Vegas?
How they gonna move to Vegas too?
Hey, everybody trying to leave
out.
How
they gonna move to Vegas too? How they gonna move to the Raiders? You think the Raiders gonna lie to
them? Bruh, bruh.
That's they stated.
Everybody's trying to leave out of California.
All the teams are trying to leave out of California.
It's common knowledge. Everybody knew this.
We picked up that pitcher, what's his name? We picked up a pitcher, I think he's from the San Diego Padres. Man, what's his name, man? Oh, man, he's a closer. Man, what was his name? Oh, man. But anyway, the Astros just picked up a pitcher out of California. I think it was,
oh, you're talking about the one that's making all that money?
I think he was a Padre. Yeah, he got like a 92.
Yeah, he got all that money.
So you're right. People are climbing up out of there, trying to get up out of there, man. Like something get ready to go down to California. All the teams want to leave. You know what I'm saying?
Hey, think about it. Back in the day when we was in school, remember they told us by 2000, California wasn't going to be another Hawaii, Annie? Remember they told us? Hey. But, okay. So, now, let's talk about the other coach. Bill Belichick. You think he's going to sign with Atlanta? They done had two meetings with him. They done did two interviews with him. He's the front runner.
I don't see why not. You know what I'm saying? I don't see why not. I mean, once you're a coach, that's what you do, that's what you love. You go where the,
Do you go where the talent is or do you go where the money at?
In that case, I'd probably go, it's not like he's not an accomplished coach, so at this point it don't matter. If it's just about money, then let it be about money. But, you know, I don't know any coaches that just lay down at any time anyway, you know what I mean? So, I don't know. Like, I don't know these decisions that these coaches make, but they got their reasons for it, you know what I'm saying? They already did. Just look at it. They already paid. You know what I'm saying? It's not like they looking for no more bread, really, unless they spending their money recklessly or something like that. So, really, you know, Obviously, they're looking for, you know what I'm saying, that next win, you know? Because, I mean, if I was a coach and I was paid like that, I would just be looking for that next win. Wherever that next win was is where I want to go. Because when you start making all that kind of bread, all you want to do is just get in the history books as one of the baddest, best coaches that were out there anyway. So,
well, Taz just said Belichick is going to Seattle.
Okay.
I don't know where he get that from.
Why would he go to Seattle?
Yeah, why would he go there? Seattle have their front runner.
I don't know, man. Like I said. I don't know. I don't follow these cats like that, so I don't know.
Now I have to say congratulations to the new coach of those Las Vegas Raiders. They took the interim tag off of their guy that came in and went 8-5 the last couple of games, 8-5 to finish the season, something like that. Mm-hmm. But they took the interim tag. They took the interim tag off him and they made him the head coach. So he's now the new head coach of the Raiders.
Okay.
Well, it's been a lot of Antonio Pierce. Antonio Pierce. That's the name. Yeah, he's now the new head coach. I'll be interested to see what they're gonna pay him salary wise.
But you see, let's get down and dirty with it.
Okay.
Honestly, the whole thing is all these movements and all these coaches moving, all these. It's the same thing when all these players move and it's like every single time it's like let's try. When you play basketball when you was a kid and you wanted you know your pick, my pick, and you want to pick your guys to get on the court. You always try to stack the team. And then you had those teams play together all the time. And these are the coaches, the coaching staff. This is the team that play together all the time. The guys behind the whole scene. These guys that network the whole thing. What do you think we can do? They got the analytics behind them. They got everybody else telling them. But what do you think we can do if we can get this player or we can get this player? So when they start making that network, it's the same network that these coaches are doing too. Well, maybe if you move over here, they put the pieces of a puzzle together because they really do have the analytics behind the whole thing. They're trying to stack the deck. For whatever reason, they stack the deck. I want the best team. I want this, or I want to move here. And then maybe this dude right here, maybe we can get this trade. Maybe we can get this trade and we can build in this position. So if I'm going to be a coach, I'm moving into a position saying, all right, look, we're going to restructure the team. We're going to build around this particular player. You know what I'm saying? So it's all analytics. It's the same game. They stack the deck just like they used to do when you were kids in the gym playing basketball. You just wanted the best five out there anyway. But it didn't even matter if you went on the best five, you still went out there and you played. And every now and then you would upset the losers. You know what I'm saying? It's the same thing. So they got the same thing. It's levels to it, man. There's so many different levels to this thing. So that's just one of the levels. When you start seeing all these people move here and move there, you really don't understand. And the media gonna tell you whatever. You can have Stephen A. come on tell you whatever. And then we're looking at that and say, well, maybe that's right. But either way, they got a bigger game behind them because they stack the deck anyway. They know what's going on. They're doing this because they see in the future. We don't know how much longer. You might have 2 years left. You might have, you know what I'm saying? So they don't know, they're looking at draft picks. They look at the whole thing. They don't stop just at the small areas. They build on a bigger scale. That's what they do. Because it's nothing but when it all comes down to all at the end of it, it's nothing but entertainment. Not only is it just entertainment, it's scripted entertainment. So everybody yelling at their TVs, they know it's scripted. They know ain't no way they let that receiver open that wide right there. Ain't no way you can close in on that route. It's all scripted entertainment, if you ask me. But everybody loves it. And the more scripted it is, it becomes a soap opera to all of us dudes. That's our soap operas. You know what I'm saying? We love it because it's our soap operas.
WWE is our soap opera.
Like that pass supposed to hit your hands like that and you can't catch it.
WWE is our soap opera.
No, I don't even watch it anymore, man. I left it alone, man.
Okay, so question asked. Where do you think Marvin Harrison Jr. is going in the draft? Marvin Harrison Jr., the wide receiver from Ohio State? Yeah, Ohio State. The Ohio State.
The
Ohio State. Listen, I've been telling everybody this ever since the middle of the NCAA college football season.
Number one overall
pick is going to be Caleb Williams. Caleb Williams is going to be number one. Marvin Harrison is going to be number two. Marvin Harrison Jr. is going to be number two. Then the old senior citizen quarterback from Oregon, he going to go number three. Man, bruh, that joke is old, bro. That joke is about to be 40. He got to be 40. I know what to call him is trying to make a move to get the number one draft pick. Who is the number three team is trying to go up? Let's see. Hold on, let me see. I'm got it right here. Where is it? God dog it. I had it earlier today. Let me go back here. I'll be hiding stuff from myself. All right, so Chicago got number one draft pick by way of a trade that they did with the Panthers.
Yeah, Carolina.
Okay. Let's see. Number two is the Washington
New
Commanders. New England number three.
Commanders
is number two because of their strength of schedule. They had the same record.
So Commanders in New England.
Yeah, yeah. And then, so Arizona, Washington, and New England finished with 4-13 records. But so they had to go by the strength of schedule. And that put the Washington Commanders second. But the Patriots is trying to move to number one and get that. Now, if they trade up, they're gonna flip the draft and Caleb won't go number one. They'll take Marvin Harrison Jr. at number one. They'll take Marvin Harrison Jr. number one. And then that'll put Caleb around fourth or fifth.
What team needs what though? You know what I mean? Like,
well,
who needs what team lacking receivers?
Washington need a receiver. The Patriots need a receiver.
You know, you have to look at it that way too. So a lot of trade picks are gonna go.
The Giants need receivers. They need linemen too, so a lot of team are in a lot.
Kansas City could use. You know what I mean?
They do.
Who else does Mahomes have? You know, I mean, he hits Kelsey a lot. But who's there?
Taz saying the same thing. Harrison gonna be the first wide out, but Caleb's gonna be the number one overall. Dallas need to go into the draft and pick a coach. Now, bruh.
I'm gonna let you talk about your own team like that.
So. Y'all know I'm a diehard Cowboy fan. And I was mad. When we lost. I'm mad. And I was so mad at the game. Now, my current living situation, we are at the hotel because we had some water damage at our house. So I'm thinking, hey, Dallas gonna win. We're gonna go down to the bar downstairs. We're gonna sit down, me and my dad, both of us Cowboy fans. He got on his coat. I got on just a blue shirt. We're gonna enjoy this game. They scored the first time, literally. Daddy was up like this. They scored. Daddy did this. They scored again. Daddy did like this. They scored again. He went like this. My niece was up here. My niece then was up here. And they start, after the third score, they just start playing on my daddy's belly. I was like, oh my God. It was crazy. I was like, man, Jesus. But
they did all right. They just didn't do enough. So remember, like I'm saying this. I don't care who gets who, who goes where. It's always gonna come down to the scripts in the end. It's always gonna come down to the betting lines. It's always gonna come down. Why do you think FanDuel is so huge right now? All these betting sites, so you can bet all the way down to the last second almost. You know what I mean? You can never do that before. That was never a thing before. Now you can bet on any aspect of the game. I remember I was a little bit one night. I'm telling this little story right here now. But it'll be quick. But I was a little bit one night. Went over to one of my partner's house, man. I was like, man, what's going on, man? Chilling. So, you know, we sit out in his garage, man, chill out, watch, you know, watch games, all this other stuff. And, he, you know, his son, he used to play football. His son, before he messed up, you know, messed up, like, his back or something like that. But anyway, so I'm talking to him like, man, yeah, well, what we going to do? What you got going on? Because he's a big Raiders fan. Like, he's from California. Huge Raiders fan. He don't care where they go, where they move to.
You talking about old C Fox, man. Yeah, you talking about that old Fox.
Talking about C Fox, man. So, you know, Fox is always like, yeah, man. And he gets so disgusted with, like, they can't miss a play. They can't, you know what I'm saying? Defense can't slack. You know what I'm saying? You ain't supposed to give up them 2 yards, you know? Fox gets so mad. That he started, you know, he liked to turn stuff over in his garage. He liked to throw stuff. And I was like, man, it's entertainment, bro. Always remember this is just entertainment.
Hey,
man, it don't matter.
Next time you go to Fox, listen. Next time you go to Fox house, and he start acting up, I need you to play the song.
I gotta sing that thing again.
You can hear. Tell him he can't win. Yeah, everybody on the chat heard it. Yeah, everybody heard it. You the one couldn't hear. But yeah, take them headphones out your ears and you'll be able to hear. But all right. So listen. We got to get ready to wrap this thing up, but before we go, we got to talk about one more quick thing.
What's this?
It's been through the rumor mill, and it was said as a joke. It was said as a joke. But one of the participants said, "If you think you ready." And I'm paraphrasing. If you think you're ready, we can do it. What do you think about the potential fight John Fury, that's Tyson Fury's daddy, versus Mike Tyson.
You know what? If they can, first of all, I'm gonna put my two cents in.
It ain't got to be nothing but an exhibition. It could be, listen, it could be a 5-round, 3-minute exhibition.
If they can get this sanction, first of all, let's look at that. If they can get this sanction, and we already, now, hear me out now. If they can get this sanction, now we already know Mike Tyson can get sanctioned. Because Mike Tyson just fought Roy Jones. I would say just fought. You know what I'm saying? That was pretty cool. That was all right. You know what I'm saying?
But that was the exhibition.
Right. Well, I'm saying they still had to sanction the fight either way, exhibition or not. So either way, if they can get this sanction, I don't know, I hadn't even looked at any of John Fury's tapes. Like, you know what I'm saying? I heard he was a beast. You know what I'm saying? So he might have, I don't know, has he ever even fought Shannon Briggs? You know what I'm saying? Or somebody like that. So I don't know what his, you know. So he's not like a guy that I follow. He talked big. He talked real big. But I think if they did fight, it'd be cool. I don't think it'd be millions of dollars, you know what I'm saying? You know, like they think that it would bring in, because I don't think it'd be promoted that well, first of all.
Hey, you don't think so?
I don't think it'd be, I think they try to hype it a little bit, but it wouldn't be promoted like that, you know?
Okay, so his professional
division really is kind of, it's lacking. The heavyweight division and boxing is really lacking right now. You know what I mean? So like when Deontay Wilder, when he just kept getting beat up three times, and now he's going back to the drawing board, you know what I'm saying? So he got to come back. So Deontay in the heavy ranks was the guy. He was the guy in the heavy rank. But now, you know what I'm saying? Now Tyson Fury up there, and it's just kind of like, all right, you know what I'm saying, the Gypsy King, whatever they like to call him and all that. It's just not explosive like that, where everybody just wants to see him box everybody. So you got to start putting a lot of these other fights around it. Oh, well, Tyson the fighter's daddy. You know what I'm saying? Because you got a real name that still carries weight in Mike Tyson. You know what I'm saying? So now, if they want to go at it, if they can sanction the fight, then it'd be cool, but I don't think it'd make that kind of bread like that. It'd be cool to see, you know?
Okay, so he had 13 professional fights. His record was 8-4-1.
Come on, man.
He started off 0-1.
So people gonna look at that. People gonna look at that and be like, "Well, why fight him? Because he named his son after Mike Tyson." This has just become a payday.
I ain't even thought about that. I wonder, did he name his son after Mike Tyson?
I'm telling you. So that just become a payday for him. So I talk as much trash as I can to try to get the legend Mike Tyson in that, because Mike Tyson gonna put people in the seats at this point. You know what I mean?
Mike Tyson gonna put somebody in a coma. That was gonna happen. He gonna. It's gonna be like my man on Harlem Night. come Saturday night. Somebody get knocked out.
If they do it, it'd be cool for a three round expedition fight.
I got the supreme undercard for that. The Battle of the Midgets.
Oh, man.
Kevin Hart versus Cat Williams in a 3-round exhibition. 6 ounce gloves. No weight limit. I'd do one better.
Same two. But just on a super comedy, just, you know what I'm saying, some wild and out comedy type stuff.
Kat already did that.
Go at each other, like, you know what I'm saying, like shooting the dozens back in the day. Y'all just tell, you give him 2 minutes, give him 5 minutes to tell your mama jokes, and then, you know what I'm saying?
Well, he challenged him to that. He challenged him to that, and he didn't answer the challenge. He challenged Cat Williams. Challenged him to that. He challenged him.
Who gonna stand in there with Cat Williams?
No, this before he even did. This before he did Club Chi Chi.
He done done what he done now. Who gonna stand in the ring with him like that?
This was.
It don't matter. Even before then, what I'm saying, it could have happened before. It could have happened 3, 4, 5 years ago. It never happened, right? So who gonna stand in there with Cat right now? Who that know they got dirt on is gonna stand in there and go joke with Cat Williams right now?
Nobody got dirt on. Nobody got dirt. Nobody got dirt on Cat.
That's what I'm saying. That's what I'm saying. So all these other, if Cat was lying on Club Shay Shay, if he was lying, then obviously you'd have everybody coming in and saying you're lying, of course.
Well, I saw.
If y'all want to do a comedy extravaganza with any of them, ain't nobody gonna stand in there with Cat. Only person I know that can stand in Cat with a clear conscience probably Dave Chappelle.
Listen, I saw the video of Cat Williams running the 40. And he say he was a 4-2, 4-3 40 runner.
I doubt that. Yeah, he's probably 4-3. And running. I doubt the rest of that.
Well, you know he'll be in Columbia next week. I mean next month in February.
Right on.
And tickets shot up. After Club Shay Shay.
Shoot, I wish you the best of luck.
Take a shot out.
I mean, because I know everybody's been paying attention to it. And I'm going to get off this, because I know we got to cut it short. But I know everybody's been paying attention to this and how all these other people were talking about how Cat was so generous. And he'd go to all these clubs and he would bless him with a little bit of this and bless him with a little bit of that every now and then because he really loved the true comics. So, you know. I really think the guy, you know what I'm saying, he kind of stand up when it comes to that. You know, I ain't cutting for nobody because it ain't like I know, you know what I'm saying, but hey, somebody else prove me wrong. Yeah, 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 well I don't know, I don't know, man, it's, 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 uh, Taz say he hyping his show up in Tupelo right now. Can't Tupelo,
wait
Tupelo, Mississippi.
Tupelo, yeah. Mississippi. I'm checking out my cheat sheet over here real quick. See if we talked about everything we were supposed to hit on. Yeah, we talked about everything we were supposed to hit on. Oh, we'll save this for the next show. We're going to talk about Doc Rivers and his return. That's going to be on the next one. Doc Rivers, remind me. We're going to talk about Doc Rivers and his return. We're going to talk about Alabama and their new coach. We're going to talk about Texas A&M and their new coach. So this looks like it's going to be a heavy NCAA episode, the next one. We're going to talk about NCAA. We should have our third partner in crime should be here, and he will be starting giving out his brown liquor picks.
Brown liquor picks.
AK, the brown liquor is AK-47, AK 50, 40, what is it, 56 or 36? APK 56 or something like that.
No, APK 6.
APK 6, yes.
Yeah.
Is the official, is the official sponsor of the Brown Liquor Pick. So, yeah, we will be doing AP 6. I'm waiting on my bottle to get here so we can toast it up, you know. I'll toast it up in my mind.
I'll tell you this right here, man. I think it's going to be a fun season, covering the ECBL and then, you know, all other little stuff in between, man. So, you know, anybody feel free to call in. You know, we can talk about anything. You know, this is dedicated, you know, honestly to everybody that want to, you know, get in. Let's talk about it, man. Let's talk about it. Let's have some fun. It's all about having fun. And the ECBL is this, so you know we're going to have some fun for a lot of these guys. We talk a lot. We're going to talk a lot. So y'all go out there and perform. If you don't perform, we're going to talk about it.
We're going to talk about it. Mr. Erskine College. I might come out there saying Mr. Erskine College. I'm just talking trash. I'm going to talk trash. Hey.
Saturday, January 27th, the Kingdom Life and Basketball Club versus the Let It Fly Web Dogs. You know, over there in Inman.
South Carolina. I might stop through there because you know I got to go up to Greenville. So let me see how far Inman is from.
That's all right. But I'll be home for pretty much all the summer. So we'll hit it up, man. We'll go to
Greenville. I don't believe nothing you say when you say you coming home. I don't believe you. I don't believe nothing you be saying when you say you coming. Nigga, I be here waiting on you. I be here like a crackhead waiting at the mailbox and you'll never show up. The next day, you know, they say, well, you know, stuff done change. He ain't coming.
Hey, you gotta wait at the bus stop. Come in on the bus. Don't wait at the mailbox, wait at the bus stop.
So Inman is up like you going to Cherokee. No, I ain't gonna make that one, buddy. I might, cause that's right on the other side of Spartanburg. So yeah, I'll make that. That's straight up 26. Yeah, hour and a half. Man, let's ride. I'll ride up there, no problem. I'll hit the owner up. Yeah. Matter of fact, I'll take my laptop and set up a camera. And we gonna talk trash while we watching the game. That's what we gonna do. That's how we getting it in this year. We talking trash. But ladies and gentlemen, we got to go. We said we was coming on for 30 minutes, but we done been here almost. I done lost count. Let's see.
I got stuff to do in the morning, man. So I got to go pick up the kids.
Oh, yeah. I forgot. Yeah, be safe on that road. You be safe on that road. We done been on here for 1 hour, 6 minutes, so we done went over 30 minutes. It'll be all right. Our sponsor will love us, so we'll be good. Ladies and gentlemen, this is DJ Skyrocket. That is my partner in crime, the one and only Side Soldier B. Soldier Boi B.
Yes, indeed.
Straight out of Huffman, Texas.
Out of Huffman, Texas, courtesy of East Oak, South Carolina, where my heart is.
We'll see you next time. Don't forget the official, this was just a teaser, the official first episode is February the 4th, right here on Facebook from 4 to 6. We'll be talking about everything ECBL and anything else that's going on in the sporting world. But now we have to do this. We have to tell you two fingers.
Hey.
Did you hold real quick? Did you come up with a slogan yet?
No, I got to work on those. Those come during the season, man.
Okay. Well, we got to tell you right now, two fingers, peace. We'll holler at you later. We out. See ya.
Don't. Now here's what I want you all to do.